Don't go making me throw you back in there now, eh?
Odin and Bahama, that's it for all again.
Finally crawled out of the crypt, eh? You look like it. Although I thank you for doing us the courtesy of covering up.
Don't.
Well, still have a bit of fight left in you. Then listen. I've arranged a meeting with Gav. In case you've forgotten, you're the one he's been putting his nose to work for.
For nothing.
Just listen. While you've been relaxing in your cell, Gav's been busy sniffing out your dominance. And according to his last report, he's picked up a scent. Gav's gone to a fair bit of trouble for you. The least you can do is hear the poor bugger out. He's going to meet us at the Kingsfall. Pack your stuff. We'll leave as soon as you're ready.
Look what the curl dragged in. Coin purse weighing you down? You're rubbing me blind, you know. You'll not find a better price than that. It'd better all be here. You'll not find a better price than that. Finished, are you?
Make it quick. So, what'll it be? It'd last you a good while. Anything else?
I suppose not.
Did I mention there'd be deadly beasts? There'll be deadly beasts. Nothing a train is. Nothing can't handle them.
How reassuring.
You're welcome for that and the shortcut.
Maybe they're friendly like Sogol. So maybe they're not.
A little help.
Let's try and stay out of its path.
Remember when I said there'd be deadly beasts? Well, the shrubs in these parts aren't much better.
Only one thing to mention this now.
You're finished!
Well, that's the underground sorted. I'll take it from here. Mind your head.
A wyvern.
I can see that. Doesn't have to be a friend of yours, does it?
My wounds, boy.
Must be a nest nearby. Keep your eyes open.
Well, it appears we won't be going this way. I'll admit I hadn't counted on that.
What is it, boy? At least one of us knows these woods. Thank you, Torgal.
Well, they look not too happy. And for once, you've got my phone.
My wounds, boy! That's it! That's over! Stay down!
This is stupid. I like wolves.
I don't think they care, Sid.
We did what had to be done.
Doesn't mean I have to like it.
No. No, it doesn't. This shouldn't take too long.
So much for your shortcuts.
What? Still short. Just not quite as quick. But it'll be a damn sight quicker if you help me.
My thoughts exactly.
Boy. Torkoal!
Aye, aye. Someone's got the ump. Where he stops, no one knows.
I doubt he'll do that, eh?
Not if we kill him first.
Can't take much more of it. Let's run it.
Clive, what exactly do you plan on doing when you find this dominant of fire?
What do you think? I'll show him the mercy he showed my brother, and cut out the tongue of any man who tries to talk me out of it.
All right. Forest dark enough as it is.
Holding back.
A little help.
I can end this quickly. Not this time.
My wounds, boy.
And we'll be in Lost Wing in no time.
In no time. Right.
My wounds, boy!
At least they're not giant lizards.
What on Lady of the Wind?
Not this time.
At least they're not giant lizards.
What on Lady of the Wind?
Ah!
Toggle!
You didn't even care.
Great to see you.
Choose that.
A little help.
this time.
What's this? Thirds is?
You. Newcomer.
I'd been cast out and left for dead when Sid found me. There's not a day goes by I don't count my blessings.
So many uses.
Have you come for a tale? Orper. Now this, I believe you will find most interesting. What subject shall we consider today?
Not so long ago, this here was a thriving trade route. Then the blight came. The people left. And just like that, it was deserted. Making it the perfect little shortcut. Gab's waiting for us up ahead. Come on. Still feeling sorry for yourself?
Please.
Think about it, Clive. The rumours all point to... That was an Imperial signal. They shouldn't be here. The old fort's been abandoned for years. Our little chat can wait. I need to see what the bastards are up to. You go on ahead and meet up with Gav.
But we both know that...
No buts about it.
This is stupid. I'm the dominant of fire. We sent Gav on a wild goose chase. Perfect little shortcut, Sid. Straight to a nest of bloodthirsty beasts. much further now.
Excellent. Another fight.
What is it, boy?
After him! Don't let him escape!
Gav!
Who goes there? This one's a deserter. Take his head!
Out of my way.
You made your choice.
That's enough.
Keep your distance, boy.
Stay down.
Get him. Sick of Torgo.
Clive, what's the situation?
You're late.
Get in trouble.
What?
The Imperials are on his tail. We have to get to him before they do.
Understood. I'm here to even the odds. Any objections?
I'll take the dragon. You take the dragoon.
My wounds, boy.
Die, you bastard!
That hurt me more than it hurt him. Sorry, lad. Don't know how much help I'm gonna be here. All right. One down, one to go.
Got my wounds, boy.
Ah!
when could these bastards fly? The what goes up must come down. Bloody time waster. Come on, let's finish him off.
My wounds, boy.
Come on. There. Clive doesn't have your nose, I said. He'd stumble off a cliff, I said.
Well, that's a trouble with a nose like mine. Can't help sticking it where it's not wanted. But if it wasn't for you two, my sniffing days would be over.
Thank you. Truly.
So, what news?
Well, found out where your friend's heading, for one thing.
Gav, I...
Him and his mate are on their way to your old stomping ground, Rosaria. You should have seen what they did to the Imperials who tried to stop them. There's no question about it. He's a dominant of fire, all right.
He can't be.
Clive, I saw you turn into an icon before my very eyes. And yes... There's a good chance it was you who killed the Phoenix. But we weren't alone, were we? There was the fellow you saw enter the whirlwind. I saw him too. You didn't dream it, Clive. He's out there.
But who is he?
Don't ask me. I don't bloody know. But I do know one thing. You're gonna find him and find out. After all, you swore an oath.
What?
You swore you'd avenge your brother's death. that you'd never rest until you'd hunted down the man responsible. So, find out if this man's responsible and kill yourself if he's not.
Sid, I...
Don't thank me. Thank Gav.
Thank you, Gav.
Yeah, well, yeah.
No birds returning this year.
The deadlands have swallowed their roosts, like as not. We're running out of time.
We'll be in Rosaria in a day or two.
Back to where it all began. He must be stopped.
Spitting great gouts of fire he was, like a bleeding volcano.
Ever seen a volcano?
What? You think I'm having you on?
Clive! Your friend! She's awake!
Right.
Go to her, you fool. Right, you lot. Enough slacking. Goots, come with me. Gav, go and get those wounds seen to.
Oh, give it to me straight. How long have I got?
So?
All in good time. Let's make ourselves scarce.
Jill.
Let's get this fixed before someone...
It's true, then. It really is you.
It is.
You're alive.
So are you. I still can't believe it. Are your wounds healed?
Yes. Taya told me what happened. You saved my life.
After nearly taking it.
I had no idea. Forgive me, but how did you ever come to be there, Jill? Fighting for them.
The Iron Blood. They invaded not long after the news arrived about Phoenix Gate. Rosaria had lost her leaders. The duchy was in chaos. The Iron Kingdom saw our weakness and pounced upon it. They killed the men and captured the women.
And took you back to Ironhome.
I thought they meant to have their fun with me before the end. But the end never came. My powers awoke and everything changed. It all happened so fast.
We were told that the Iron Blood had captured a dominant and planned to bring her on their latest crusade.
They gave me a choice. To fight for them on the battlefield or see my countrywomen slaughtered.
And they call us dominant.
What? What happened, Clive? What happened at Phoenix Gate?
It was me. I killed Joshua.
No, that's not true. I know you. You wouldn't do that.
It's the truth. I changed into him again. Not long ago. The second icon of fire. The one responsible.
Clive.
When I think back to that night... The hooded man, he spoke to me. What did he say?
Sidequests.
We have found you. What did he mean?
Clive, we should go back there, to Phoenix Gate. I need to know what really happened. And so do you. You need to know for certain. And if what you told me is true, and you did what you said you did, then we will face it together.
Jill, I... All right.
You'll be needing a change of clothes, then. Out you go, your lordship. We wouldn't want you getting overexcited.
Sorry.
I'll see you soon, then, Clive.
I should be ready, too. We've a long journey ahead of us.
We're looking at half a dozen, maybe more.
Their bunks are made up.
You! Newcomer! I need help.
What's the matter?
It's my assistant. She left to gather soil, and I've seen nothing of her since. I cannot concentrate one whit for fear of what might have happened. Please, I beg of you. Will you go and check? I have to know.
All right, I'll go.
Marvelous. Thank you. You'll be rewarded for your time, of course.
Whereabouts is she?
Gotan's Bales. It's on the outskirts of Lostwig. Not the safest place for an unaccompanied bearer, perhaps, but the soil there is second to none. Now go, and do not linger. Why, it may already be too late.
They even have a Moogle. I've never seen one in the flesh. I'm sure it's said in my father's bestiary that they live deep in the forest, and that they never reveal themselves to humans. Nectar, you say? Clive. So it would seem. That sounds painful.
I trust you're settling in?
Gradually getting used to the place.
I'm glad to hear it. I was hoping you might be persuaded to come to my aid once more. Your services will be rewarded, of course.
I don't doubt it. Seems to be the way around here.
We strive to be better than those we once served. Now, as to the task itself, I am once again in need of a pair of hands to deliver sustenance to our esteemed companions. I have three meals for three industrious souls. What say you?
I'd be happy to help.
Marvelous. The three individuals you'll be seeking out are busying themselves about the hideaway. You'll find one by the entrance, another in the bunks, and the other guarding the cells. Thank you once again, Clive.
Just don't have enough teams to follow every lead.
Ooh, something smells good. For me, I hope.
It is. Courtesy of Kenneth.
Oh, my thanks. These birds are needy creatures. They don't like me running after the fat chocobo behind their backs.
They must keep you busy.
Ah, there's never a moment's rest. Probably for the best I eat down here, reeking of the stables as I do. I'd only put people off their food. And who has time to wash and dress for dinner when they've got little darlings like these to wait upon, eh? Anyway, thanks for the food, and be sure to give Kenneth my regards.
Back so soon? Fancied another kip in the cells, did you?
Can I send me? He thought you might be hungry.
He wasn't wrong. The way my gut's been growling, I'd have curls running scared.
Guard duty down here can't be much fun.
It's not. But sometimes folk need locking up, and someone has to watch over them. I help people sleep at night, and that's not a boast many can make. You keep yourself on the right side of these bars now, you hear me?
I wouldn't give for some wild Mickey berries.
Can I help you?
Kenneth sent me.
Ah, wonderful. Do you hear that? Our food has arrived. Does your appetite still elude you?
Is he sick?
I'm afraid so. Those no longer in need of a physica's immediate ministrations are sent here for further rest. I tend to those who cannot tend to themselves, which leaves me very little time for anything else. Happily, Kenneth sees that I stay fed. I would be lost without the kindness of good people like him and yourself. Thank you.
I think that's everyone. I better let Kenneth know.
We're looking at half a dozen, maybe more.
Ah, you're back. All done? Wonderful. Here, your reward, as promised.
The hideaway is quite something. Everyone has their place.
A fact we are proud of, believe me. I'm glad you've witnessed it for yourself. You have your place, too, of course, as you have just so capably proven, and you will always have a place with us, should you desire it.
It's kind of you to say so.
It is the truth, and not a soul among us would deny it. I look forward to all that you will bring to our little community.
Someone's in trouble.
Down.
them get away.
You lose.
Are you hurt?
It would have been worse if you hadn't come along. Wait, I've seen you around the hideaway. You're new, aren't you?
I'm Clive.
And I'm Martel. But what are you doing here?
Looking for you. This is no place for a bearer on her own.
I noticed that. But this soil's not going to collect itself.
Then what if I gathered it for you? You could head back to the hideaway. Just exactly what sort of dirt is it that you need?
What I need is soil. But I'd be a fool to refuse your help after what just happened. It's the good stuff you're looking for. Dark, rich, fragrant. You'll know it when you find it.
Dark, rich, and fragrant. Right. Well, you should hurry back. Bohemil seemed worried enough that he might come looking for you himself.
That seems unlikely, but I won't argue with you. Thanks.
Soil, then. There's certainly enough of it here. But is it dark, rich, and fragrant? That should be enough. I'd better get it back to the hideaway.
There you are. And? All safe and sound?
Well, yes, she's standing right there.
Not the girl. The soil. Did you bring it?
Yes. Here.
Glorious! When Martel came home empty-handed, I almost had a fit. But with this, my research can continue. First and foremost come the measurements. I must know how much ether each sample contains. From there...
Wait, so you were never...
Worried about me? Sorry to disappoint you, but the only thing he worries about is his research.
But that's...
That's all right. It's just how he is. And if it wasn't for him, we wouldn't be growing anything in these ruins. It's a small price to pay. Although, you shouldn't have to pay it too. Did he even offer you anything for helping? Ugh. Here. I know it's not much, but it's something, at least. I wish I could offer you some fruit, too, but you're not likely to thank me if I do. Still, we'll grow something worth eating one of these days, and when we do, you'll have first pick.
Research can continue apace.
fertilizer is complete.
I can really do with a proper place of tree.
What do you want?
To say farewell. We're leaving.
Good decision. Better that than buried out there in the black. You've got a lot to thank that girl for, you know.
I know. And I will.
Now, what do you really want? We both know you don't come here for conversation. You'll not find a better price than that. It'd better all be here. I'll be thankful you got that much. I reckon I can find a buyer. Off you go, then. And best of luck.
I should probably say thank you to Gav, too.
Can't you see I'm busy here? So, what'll it be? And? Make it quick. I'm saying for you, dear. Not bad, if I do say so myself. No scratches, all right? And?
Your mind's made up, is it?
We'll be leaving for Rosaria as soon as we're able.
Back down memory lane, eh? Rosaria ain't what she used to be, Clive, and not since the Imperials moved in. First sign of trouble, you make straight for Martha's Rest and ask for the landlady. She's a friend of the cause. Tell her you're with Sid, and she'll help you out.
Understood. Thank you, Gav.
Yeah.
I'd be lost without you.
Yeah, I'm just doing my job. No need to make such a fuss. You take care, all right? Oh, I'm crap at goodbyes. Where's Sid when you need him?
Give him my regards when he gets back.
I will.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Ready, my lady?
Ready.
Rosaria. It's been 13 years.
But this breeze, the smell of the grass, it's just as I remember it.
You haven't been back either?
I couldn't. Bran did keep a close watch on each other in the Imperial Army. You'd get beheaded just for knowing a deserter. The only way out was on a mission.
I see.
But mostly I was afraid. Afraid to go back.
I know.
But I'm here now. Thanks to you. We should press on.
That inn at the top of the hill must be Martha's Rest. Gav said the landlady's a friend.
But can we say the same for her patrons?
Imperials don't tend to take well to those with my mark. If anyone asks, I'm a branded soldier, sworn to protect my noble mistress.
Look at the fuse on this.
Get them all you've got, boys.
Stay down.
That's enough.
them all you've got for it.
Yeah.
boy.
Finished building the bridge then.
After what happened at Phoenix Gate, it didn't seem the highest priority.
Oi! Here, you couldn't give me an hand, could you? Typical. A bloody bearer. Just when I thought my luck had changed. Still, better a crumb of crystal than an empty hand, I suppose. Though it pains me to use another man's branded. Here, you understand me, don't you? I need your help. These blasted birds must have caught whiff of my cargo, and now they've got me surrounded. And it was funny, late as it was. I've got something special needs delivering before the rest, but I dare not leave my cart untended. You couldn't run it up to Martha's Rest for me, could you? Needs to get there quick, mind.
Fine.
That's the spirit. All right. Here. You hand that to the stable master and no one else. I'm owed a little something for it. If he gives it to you, pass it along to your master by way of thanks. Be off with you then. And don't go taking any detours on the way.
Don't let them get away!
Keep your distance, Paul. Distance, boy.
One more.
Give them all you've got, boy.
are. Martha's Rest. Stable master, I was asked to deliver this to you.
This is for me, right enough. Not sure what some bearer is doing bringing it to me, though. Where's that fool of a peddler got to?
He couldn't come himself. His cart surrounded by wild chocobos.
Huh. Sounds about right. He'll have it full of geezal greens, no doubt. Crammed with him, if I know him.
Gizelle Greens.
Chocobos go mad for them, don't they? And if you forget to seal the cart up tight, the smell gets out, and birds come running from miles around. Don't get me wrong. They're a fine investment for a savvy merchant, especially around these parts. But you can't get greedy, as our mutual friend is learning the hard way. Still, I got my wares, and that's all that matters. Be sure to pass your master my regards.
Excellent. Another fight.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Give them all you've got, boy.
I don't care what your orders are, Brandon. You keep that sword. Get it, boy!
Let's go and find out, shall we?
And he goes to East Pool, leaving in the park.
If it weren't for that mark, I'd be on you. You ain't pulled that sword from its scabbard.
What are you after? Thanks very much. Take care out there, eh?
It was good, honest work.
Excuse me. Would you happen to be the landlady?
Depends who's asking, and why they have an Imperial bearer with them.
For protection, which hopefully won't be needed, if you can advise me on the safest route to the west.
It's your friend here I'd be worried about. Bearers don't have an easy time of it in Rose Area. Even a strapping lad like him might attract the wrong kind of attention. And if he gets nabbed, it ain't likely to end well for you either.
Then we'll just have to stay out of the militia's way. Gav said you might be able to help us.
Follow me. Sorry for before. Can't be too wary of strangers asking questions in our game. I'm Martha, an old friend of Sid's. He said he had high hopes for a bearer who joined recently. I expect that's you. So, where is it you're headed?
For Phoenix Gate. We have questions that need answering.
Is that so? Well, if you want to avoid the garrison, the road through Eastpool's your best bet. Or it would be. If the bridge hadn't collapsed. A right bloomin' nuisance it is. We've had no trade with the village for weeks. I did ask our carpenter to take a look at it. But he went out on another job. And he hasn't come back.
Do you think something might have happened to him?
Fingers crossed he's just taking his time. The alternative don't bear thinking about.
We'll find him. And make sure he's safe. We both need that bridge repaired. Your carpenter sounds like the man to do it.
I see why Sid's got such a soft spot for you. If you could, I'd be in your debt.
You said that he went out on a job?
Right. He went down into the marshes to check on another bridge. The one by the Fallen Gate.
The marshes were dangerous at the best of times. We should hurry.
There's a ladder to the side of the gate. That's the quickest way down, if you've a head for heights. His name is Bernard. Should you find him well, tell him Martha sent you, and that he's wanted at the bridge to Eastpool.
To the marshes, then. Let's find that ladder.
He gets to Eastpool, leave him in the pile. We'll take him over when the bridge is back up.
Here's the gate. And that must be the ladder.
It's for the Golden Stables again.
I don't care what your orders are.
Get away from me!
What was that?
It came from under the bridge. Come on. There he is.
Hold on, we're coming.
That's enough.
Don't let them get away.
Stay down!
Thank you, my lady. You saved my life.
Not at all. You're Bernard the Carpenter, yes?
I am. I didn't realize my name was known so widely.
I'm a friend of Martha's. She asked us to come and find you.
Well, I'm very grateful for it. I just finished checking these piles when I turn around, I see a gang of slavering monsters looking to feast on my flesh. If you hadn't come when you did, I'd have been snipped into strips by now.
We're just glad you're safe.
I best go and give my regards to the landlady then, eh?
Actually, she asked that if we found you, we should beg you make haste to repair the bridge to Eastpool.
Of course. I said I'd take a look at it, but it clean slipped my mind. I'll head up there straight away. The trusses are still sturdy. It's just a matter of replacing the stringers and relining the deck. I'll have it done in no time.
Thank you, Bernard. We were hoping to take the road to Eastpool ourselves. We're very grateful for your help. And sorry for asking this of you after what you've been through.
I owe you my life. Fixing a bridge is the least I can do. Thank you, my lady. And you too, son. You're with Sid, ain't ya? Me and him, we go way back. Not as far as Martha mine, but far enough.
I see.
Well, I best get cracking then. You go and let Martha know I'm all right, and she'll have her bridge back soon enough.
We will.
The bridge will be fixed when it's fixed.
You ain't pulled that sword from this.
It was good, honest work building that. Duct.
Back when we had proper.
Ah, you're back. What happened? Did you find Bernard?
We did. He's fine. And he'll have the bridge to Eastpool repaired soon.
Well, thank the Founder for that.
It was lucky we found him when we did. The creatures out there are not to be trifled with.
It's the Blight's fault. They'd nothing to eat in the north, so they come down here hunting for food. He can't keep going out alone. I'll have to arrange a guard for him. But anyway, thank you. I don't have a lot to offer in return, but you're welcome to rest here until the repairs are finished.
We'd be delighted.
Can I get you a drink or anything while you wait? Flagon of Imperial Gold, perhaps? Tastes like swill, but it'll slake a thirst.
No, thank you. I prefer the truth. About why there are so few bearers around here.
Yes. There were more of them when we were young. Far more.
Is this the Empire's doing? Have they been sent away?
They have, aye. Either to the Legions or Auriflam. Seems the miners at Drake's Head are having a hard time keeping up with demand of late. So the bearers make up the shortfall. Time was, they used to dole out crystals like sugar plums, even down here in the provinces, but not anymore. Nowadays, they'll jump at any excuse to confiscate our bearers so they can be put to work elsewhere. I always knew the Empire treated their branded like shit, but after seeing it with my own eyes, well...
Congratulations on the new arrival. And you got the little laddie with you?
It was a bearer. A boy I carried for 9 long moons. A bloody bearer.
Oh, you poor thing. You gave it to the constables then?
Just left it at the garrison, aye. Let them deal with it. Couldn't wait to be rid of the blasted thing. Been wanting it gone since the moment I found out.
Well, it's all dealt with now. So no harm done, eh?
Mum, he weren't my brother, was he?
No. But you'll have one soon enough. You just have to be patient. All right?
All right.
Unbelievable, isn't it? Bearers may have been looked down on back in Archduke Elwyn's day, but they were still human beings. Now they've fallen so far, a beggar wouldn't spit on them. Since you're not drinking, do me a favor and take that to the Abbey. There's a darkness at the heart of this world, and I'd have you see it.
And we'll see it at an abbey?
Glademond Abbey, on the shore of Sorrowise Bay.
The abbot there is a friend. Tell him Martha sent you, and he'll show you what I mean.
Understood.